Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus for the month of April 2020. So let's get right into your reading, Pisces. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for this coming month of April. All right, Pisces, you have the Nine of Cups. So a lot of emotional fulfillment for some of you guys, prayers that are being answered to you. You're going to be experiencing a flow of energy for those of you guys that are in the creative field, writers, poetry, painters, musicians. You're definitely going to be inspired. And I see you guys being very inspired by energies around you, by people that are around you, or perhaps circumstances, situations that are really going to be helping you in regards to exploitation and exploring as well all of your creative outlooks. Now, like I said, I do see for some of you guys prayers being answered, being able to see or experience even miracles around you guys. Now, the energies of currently, the current obstacle for you guys is the Three of Pentacles. So you guys have to learn how to work in a group setting. For some of you guys, this could represent learning to accept help, even when you think that you're able to do it on your own. The Three of Pentacles usually indicates coming together and working, you know, as a group or in a group setting. But I feel that as an obstacle, you guys may have a tendency of not really embracing those that are trying to help you out, perhaps because you feel like you're very capable of doing it. But what Spirit is telling you is that it's okay to communicate. It's okay to show vulnerability. It's okay to receive a helping hand. There's no shame in that. And you need to learn to be more embraceful in regards to that type of energy. Now, the past and passing, we have the Four of Pentacles obtaining. So some of you guys have been challenged in regards to finances or in regards to work. For some of you guys being in a position where perhaps you feel like unfulfilled, or you feel like at this point in your life, you had some type of vision, some type of desire, and there may be some frustration in regards to feeling stuck or feeling like things are not progressing as quickly as you would want. Now, what's on your mind is the Nine of Pentacles. So for some of you guys, it is the journey of wanting to find financial stability, financial growth. Nonetheless, you do have the Chariot card here. So I do see very quick energies coming in for a lot of you guys, situations and circumstances of that are very unbeknownst to you or that are coming up as a surprise. So again, with the Three of Pentacles, I feel that for some of you guys, it could be friends, it could be relatives, it could be people that know you or that you're connected in a social aspect with them that are coming to you or giving you some type of information. For some of you guys, it could be a specific job that you've been looking for that they're aware of, and they kind of help you get in the door. For others of you, it could just signify very quickly being able to see things progress in a positive way, where you start to no longer experience any type of blockages or anything that is really, if in the past you felt like it's been difficult to even get anything that you wanted to make happen, there's been some resistance that's quickly going to be removed. That's quickly going to, it's almost this energy of opportunities that are going to be coming to you guys from like right and left. For some of you guys, there may be a challenge of having to make a decision in regards to these opportunities for self-growth. Now, your advice card here is the Four of Wands. Pisces, try the best you can to embrace being at home or within a family dynamic. I think that for some of you guys, it's necessary to, I feel that sometimes we pretty much piss and moan sometimes when we're like at a standstill or when we feel like things are not moving as quickly as we would want. But what Spirit is telling you is that you should be embracing this time within your dwelling, meaning within your home or within your family or within around your family members, your kids. Embrace this, because this quickly is going to be changing in the aspect of where you're going from feeling stuck to feeling like things are coming very quickly unfolding and not having enough time, or time management is something that is going to be important in April. Now, the energy is currently influencing you. We have the Three of Swords. So someone's definitely feeling a bit hurt or a bit betrayed. This could be people around you. This could be a relative. This could be even your partner feeling a bit let down is what I'm hearing. So for some of you guys, you may be dealing with wanting to pursue a desire or a want. For some of you guys, it could be that you're in a third party situation and what's on your mind is the desire to be single. But the advice card here is the Four of Wands, and what they're telling you is don't be very quick to make a decision, Pisces. Don't be hasty if it's you, the one that's dealing with a third party, because you may be falling for an idea. If the third person has shown you some type of who they are, quote unquote, I feel that you haven't got to know them on a deeper level, and you may be feeling like you're let down or even betrayed should you step away from your commitment and go towards this third party, or you're willing to basically give up your comforts to pursue a fantasy, basically is what they're saying. So if you are dealing with this, be careful with that. Now, you do have the Seven of Pentacles, so I do see you guys wanting to make amends or wanting to come back. So this could be you that dealt with the third party. You ended up leaving your partner for the third party, and perhaps now you're regretting that. I do see you guys wanting to come back or wanting to get back into your partner or ex-partner's life. Like I said, if you're currently going through this, just be careful and be mindful not to make a decision based off, like I said, a fantasy. Now you have the Queen of Cups here, and this is your energy, Pisces. What they're telling you is you need to learn to be more compassionate, be a little bit less selfish when it comes to love. So I know that a lot of the times Pisces are, you guys are dreamers by nature. And when things are very difficult, or perhaps you felt at some point like you've been taken for granted, like they haven't treated you well, and then you get someone giving you all the attention, it could be very easy for us to fall into that notion of, you know, there's other opportunities out there. But sometimes the grass is not greener on the other side. So just be mindful in regards to that. Now, for those of you guys that are in a long-term committed relationship, again, the desire to want to manifest some type of stability, and though there's been a bit of resistance, I do see you guys progressing and moving forward, getting more opportunities. Now, with the Three of Swords, I feel that this has a lot to do with being tested, not necessarily in your relationship, but perhaps with your children, maybe even dealing with a daughter or a son that's currently going through some type of heartbreak. What they're saying is just be as nurturing as possible and compassionate as you possibly can. They will eventually get through this, okay? So I hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll see each other soon. Bye.